Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Durham Public Schools 2023 presentation of An Evening to Shine. I'm Jordan from Easley Elementary School. We are so excited you are here. We love when our families and community come to support our hard work. My friends and I have been working really hard for tonight's show. Would you join us in creating a space where my friends are really able to shine bright this evening? I can't hear you. Will you help us? Okay, thanks. Please silence all electronic devices. I don't want you to miss anything. Also, no texting. Trust me, you will not want to take your eyes off the stage. Oh, and tonight's performance is being professionally recorded and will be available free on our YouTube channel. I want my friends on stage to be safe. No flash photography, video, or audio taping. While we love our little and older brothers, sisters, cousins, neighbors, and friends, we ask that you take the crying ones to the lobby and come back in between musical numbers.
Good job.
Oh, and keep the aisles clear and check out the emergency exits. And now, please welcome my friend and Durham Public Schools Director of Arts Education, Mr. Jeremy Tucker.
Y'all give it up for Jordan, my friend, one more time. Well, good evening and welcome to the Durham Performing Arts Center. Launched in 1982, by the Durham Public Schools Scholarship Foundation as a major scholarship fundraiser, Evening to Shine, formerly known as An Evening of Entertainment, has grown from its origins as a cabaret show in the cafeteria of Jordan High School to an event featuring over 500 performers representing schools from every single DPS school in the arts. We have a very special recognition to do before we begin. We have members of the original DPS Scholarship Foundation who actually started this event here with us this evening. And I'd like to call on past president Linda Ruth to the stage to recognize this committee. Would y'all help me give Linda a round of applause?
Good evening. It is so great to be back here at the DPAC for this incredible show and to see this house so full of people that want to celebrate the talents of these students. During our little hiatus, the DPS Scholarship Foundation merged with the DPS Foundation, and so this is our first opportunity to sort of recognize the people who not only started this foundation, but who kept it going for so many years as volunteers. And so I'd like to bring out, we have several of our former board members here this evening. I'd like to bring them out to the stage right now and introduce them to you. Represented here tonight, we have members who served from the beginning of the foundation in 1978 all the way up to our when we merged in 2020. I'd like to introduce Beth Eisenson, James Hopkins, Jane Mitchell, former DPS Arts Director Mary Casey, Lisa Kane, Pepper Hines. The DPS Arts Director who started this whole event off, Ronnie Lilly. And one of the founders of the DPS Scholarship Foundation, who has a scholarship named for her that is still active today, a $3,000 scholarship for students who excel in community service, just like this wonderful lady, Miss Rachel Lawrence. Thank you, former trustees of the DPS Scholarship Foundation, for all you've done over the years to make this event a great event for the Durham community and for DPS students.
Tonight, our students will showcase their music, dance, and visual art talents as we, the community, celebrate their successes. Speaking of success, please help me now welcome the Chief of Staff of the Durham Public Schools Foundation and former Evening to Shine performer and DPS alumni, Miss Erica Wilkins.
Thank you, Jeremy. Hey, y'all. I am so thrilled to be here today. The entire foundation is. This year, An Evening to Shine is presented by the Durham Public Schools Foundation in partnership with the Durham Public Schools. The DPS Foundation works to ensure success and equity for every DPS student, including alleviating the financial burden of post-secondary education. So tonight, the proceeds are going to go to funding the Durham Promise Scholarship. This is a scholarship that is awarded to one high school senior at every DPS high school each year. We are thrilled to partner with DPS and our event sponsors to ensure there was no cost for any student to participate in this event for the first time ever, to provide a supplement for our elementary music teachers that attended rehearsals countlessly after school with students, and to provide this incredible venue, DPAC, for our students to continue to shine. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. We hope you enjoy the show.
Thank you, Erica, and thank you to the DPS Foundation for your continued support of our schools. Tonight's presentation has representation from every public school in Durham Public Schools. More than 500 children are waiting anxiously right this moment. And have worked together to create what you are about to experience. This type of opportunity, where, as Erica mentioned, 100% of our schools collaborate together in a non-competitive environment through the arts, simply does not happen in any other part of North Carolina. Leadership is so important. Having leaders that understand the importance of the arts is vital in our community, where equity, access, and success are a priority. It is a true honor to welcome our superintendent, Dr. Pascal Mbinga, to the stage. Would you welcome Dr. Mbinga?
Thank you, Jeremy. Good evening. It's my honor to welcome you to An Evening to Shine. Each year, this show is bigger and better. I always look forward to seeing our students perform in this world-class venue. Arts are a critical part of the curriculum and the program offerings in Durham Public Schools. We are proud to offer more arts opportunities during and after school than any other school district around. Tonight, you will enjoy our talented students as they come together in harmony. For the first time, our students are also highlighted through visual arts in the program, and the theater students are assisting backstage. Most importantly, I would like to thank the teachers. We have worked countless hours with the students to prepare them for this production. I extend my thanks. I extend my thanks to all who support Durham Public Schools, and especially those friends, family, and community members who are in attendance. Mr. Tucker.
Thank you, Dr. Mavinga. Are y'all ready? Yeah. Are you sure? Yeah. I cannot wait to introduce our host MC for the evening. Pierce Freelon is a Grammy-nominated musician, author, and educator from Durham, North Carolina. He is the co-creator of Beatmaking Lab, an Emmy Award-winning PBS web series, and is the writer, composer, and co-director of the PBS animated series, The History of White People in America, an official selection of the Tribeca Film Festival. His Grammy-nominated children's music album, Black to the Future, has been featured on NPR. Brown Books for Young Readers also published his debut children's book, Daddy Daughter Day, in 2022. Remember that. It's going to be important in a little bit. And his next release, Daddy and Me Side by Side, will be published in 2023 in just a couple months, in May, I believe. Freelon is a former Durham City Councilman, a husband, and a father of two based in Durham, North Carolina, and a DPS alumni. Yeah, give it up. And keep your energy going while you please join me in welcoming DPS alumni and our host for the evening, Mr. Pierce Freelon.
Hey! Jeremy. Make some noise, Bull City! Yes! That is right. We are here for the 42nd evening to shine. Are y'all ready to see these kids shine? Listen, I've been here all day watching them sing and dance. You are in for a treat. Our students are ready. Our 10-piece band, there's a pit right here. You can't see it. The pit is lit. They're ready. Our crew is ready, but are you ready to support our DPS students? All right. Do you have the music in you? All right, let's welcome our students to the stage.
I know.
Make some noise for these kids. Wow. Yo, did that take y'all back? Whoa, whoa. You got the best of my love. Hey, they turning up over there. And you know who has the best of their love? The teachers, you know, the administrators, the people who put this together definitely have the best of their love. Yes, make some noise for that. And I just want to share a quick personal experience. I grew up here in Durham, went to E.K. Poe Elementary School, and I remember the first time I saw arts performance in schools. It was Baba Chuck Davis and the African American Dance Ensemble. You know what I'm talking about? Yo, 6'7", could just leap across the stage, such a powerful and beautiful force. He used to get our attention by saying, "I'll go," which means, "Can I have your attention?" And the response is, "Ame." Some of y'all know Baba Chuck. Let's try it out. "I'll go."
"Ame."
"I'll go."
"Ame."
It doesn't matter. I could be on my Game Boy, not paying attention, doing whatever. He says, "I'll go." I'm, "Ame." You know? So this is arts in the Durham public school system. It's so beautiful, so powerful. And we truly have a community that understands the importance of arts in schools. And we are honored to have several elected officials from the city and county governments in attendance this evening. Mayor Elaine O'Neill has devoted so much to the Durham community and is a supporter of DPS. Where you at, Mayor O'Neill? Thank you for being here. Our city council members, is Councilmember Leonardo Williams in the building? There you are in the back, good to see you, brother. Ward 3. All right, do we have any other city council members in the house tonight? Okay, we got some, I know we got some county commissioners. We have our chair, Brenda Howerton, our vice chair, Wendy Jacobs, our commissioners, Nima Sheena Burns and Heidi Carter. Please rise, our county commissioners. Thank you, thank you. Special recognition should be given to the DPS School Board, which recognizes the importance of the arts in shaping our students. Please stand, Chair Bettina Umstead, Vice Chair Emily Chavez, Board Members Natalie Beyer, Javonia Lewis, Millicent Rogers, and Alexandra Valladares. There you are. I met Millicent in seventh grade at DSA and Miss Latoya Chimflu's African dance class. What up? Okay. More shout outs. The president of Durham Tech is in the building. Please make some noise for JB Buxton. Okay, this one is a mouthful. Senior vice president of the Triangle Area Child Care Resource and Referral Services at Child Care Services Association. Linda Chappelle, make some noise for Linda Chappelle. Did I get it right? Okay. Check it out, Eagle Pride Amplified, the provost and vice chancellor of the North Carolina Central University, Dr. David Jackson is in the building. Yes. And we have vice president for Global Cloud Partners at Red Hat, Blake Shiver, and vice provost for the arts for Duke University, Dr. John Brown. Thank you for being here this evening. JB, my man. All right, and I also know that every school principal is in the house, including central office leaders. Would you principals please stand up? There they are. Thank you. And we have our DPS Principal of the Year and North Carolina Central Principal of the Year, Dr. William Logan, is in the house. Dr. William Logan, please stand. Ah, there he is. Thank you for being there. All right, so next up, we are in for a special treat from our elementary singers and dancers. But first, y'all ready for the elementary schoolers? They're ready. All right. But first, they need a little something from you. They need your permission to dance. Can y'all help me out? Do they have your permission? Put your hands together. Let's go. Y'all got a feeling in your body? Yo, it's so funny. So I'm backstage, and the teachers are backstage, you know, who taught them all the dance moves and stuff, and they're back there just dance, dance, dance. They're so into the show. It's just beautiful to see teachers who love their kids so much. They poured so much into this event. So another big round of applause for the teachers. I want to give a special shout out to our DPS Central Office staff, which has showed up tonight. Central Services staff and leadership, will you please stand? There you are. There you are. There you are. Thank you. We also just got word that Representative Zach Hawkins is in the building. Where you at, Representative Hawkins? Thank you for your service. There you are. Thank you, thank you. Now, everybody, check out your playbill. For the first time ever at an Evening to Shine, visual arts are represented inside this year's program. So flip through there. Every school has an artist represented in the playbill. And also in there, you will find ways that you can support the arts and the DPS Foundation and help make an even larger impact on the lives of our students. Additionally, you will find many local businesses who support this event through advertisement and donation of products and services. Make some noise for local businesses. Part of what makes Durham very special. We encourage you to let them know that you appreciate their support of An Evening to Shine. Now, at this time, we would like all DPS Foundation board members and former Foundation trustees to please stand. Trustees, board members, thank you. Thank you for your service. And we got a lot of, tons of arts partners in the house as well. I'm gonna name them all. We can applaud for them all at the end. NC Symphony Education Director Jason Spencer, Executive Director of the Durham Arts Council, Sherry DeVries, Executive Director of the American Dance Festival, Jody Neimreicher, Executive Director of Kids Notes, Shauna Tucker, Senior Director of Education and Community Engagement at the Carolina Theater, Shayna Adams, President of the NC Music Educators Association, Mr. Jonathan Hamill, and past President, Ms. Jasmonet Sutton. Let's hear it one more time for all these wonderful creatives. Thank you for joining us today. All right, and we gotta show some love to DPAC. We have Megan Rindox, who is the Director of Community Engagement, and Bob Klaus, who is the General Manager here. Please rise and be recognized and appreciated. Thank you. Okay. Now, in the last 2 years, DPSF has awarded 51 scholarships, and two of our recipients are here today. I would like for them to stand. Lauren Goins, a Durham Promise Scholarship recipient, graduate of J.D. Clement Early College, and now attending the North Carolina Central University. Please stand. Where you at? Okay. And we have Selena Zhang, a Durham Promise Scholarship recipient, a graduate of Jordan High School, and now attending UNC Chapel Hill. Please rise and be recognized. There you are. Wonderful. Now, I want to take a moment to acknowledge our Hillside Hornets. Last week, we experienced a tragedy of gun violence, which has rocked the entire Durham Public School system. The arts are so important in helping our community be safe and be whole. So today, on an evening where we're celebrating and recognizing the arts, I want to just have a moment of silence for the folks involved in that. Thank you. Now, there are so many world-class artists to come out of Hillside, y'all. Y'all know about lawyer, activist, poet, Episcopal priest, author of Brown versus Board of Education, Polly Murray. Make some noise for Polly Murray. All right. It's Black History Month, y'all. Y'all about to get some Black history. Y'all know about professional football player, civil rights activist, and painter, and genius Ernie Barnes. Y'all know about that? Ancestor. How about 11-time Grammy-winning gospel singer Shirley Caesar? Y'all know about that? Okay, check it out. These are all
graduates of Hillside High School. And these kids on stage, this is your next Shirley Caesar, y'all. This is your next Polly Murray, your next Ernie Barnes. And your support today is helping ensure a safe and bright future for them. So please join me in welcoming our elementary school students and singing Cover Me in Sunshine.
Just imagine people laughing.
Make some noise for these kids. Come on out here, Falcon X. Come on out here, man. Make some noise for these kids. Yes. Yo, didn't they do a great job? They did a great job. Right. Let me introduce my friend here. This is Falcon X. Everybody say, what up, Falcon? Okay. So when we say arts and schools, this is what we're talking about. Of course, there's music and dance, but there's also puppetry. This is a puppet crafted by Paper Hand Puppet Intervention in Saxbaha, North Carolina. They work a lot in schools. And we have a special treat for the kids. We're actually going to read them a little bit of a storybook, all right? This is my book, Daddy Daughter Day. Y'all want to hear a story?
Yeah!
One girl said, no. We kind of tired. We've been up here all day. All right, I'm just going to read you kind of the beginning of the book. All right. It's Daddy Daughter Day. Wake up. We can't let this day go to waste. Get out of bed or else this pillow's going in your face. I got one laugh. Okay. You know what? We can save this for another time. I think, why don't we bring Daddy Daughter Day books for all the kids? Can we do that? We got 200 children's picture books here. Bring these out. Come on, bring these out. So you're all gonna go home with a copy of Daddy Daughter Day. Give these kids a big round of applause. Yes, yes. All right. Okay, y'all can hit the curtain now. It's all good. Y'all can close it up. We're about to do something else. Okay, step up a little bit. Give them a round of applause one more time. Say bye to these kids. 1, 2, 1, 2. All right. Okay, so they asked me to show, almost closed, just a little bit more. Okay. They asked me to show y'all a little bit about what we do as artists. Falcon X, you ready to make some beats up in here? Okay, check it out. I got my loop pedal here, which is pretty cool.
It allows me to pitch down my voice really low. Good evening, Durham. How are you? All right.
So check it out. We're going to make a little Durham Public Schools beat. You ready? All right. Start off with a little hi-hat. All right, so now we have a little foundation. You wanna add some drums? Okay. Here we go. Go. Okay. Now this side I wanna hear you say, go. Durham. Okay. Public. Go. Schools. Okay, all right, y'all got it? So, on this side. Okay. I think they got it. Go. It goes like. Okay. Go. Okay. Go. Okay.
Go. All right, we made them into a little sample pad.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I said Durham Public Schools.
I said Durham Public Schools. Yeah. We said Durham Public Schools. Yeah. We said Durham Public Schools.
Make some noise for Durham Public Schools, y'all. Just having some fun up here. All right, me and Falcon X, we're gonna get out of here, but I want you to make some noise for our next group of performing students. Y'all ready for some more? DPS, Love and Magic, make some noise.
There are times when I look above and beyond. There are times when I feel your love around me, baby. I'll never forget my baby. I'll never forget.
yes, yes. Yes. Ago. Okay, y'all remember. Y'all remember Baba Chuck's lessons. All right, every educator who teaches these students has contributed to the success of this event. None of our performers could accomplish what you see on this stage without skills, all right? That's what they're learning, are skills. They are taught hard work, to cooperate with others, to believe in themselves. And tonight's show highlights vocals and choreography, the skills the students acquired in rehearsal. Our music educators, students, technicians, and musicians practice for hours and hours to produce the professional performance you're experiencing tonight. So please allow me to acknowledge our creative team who has inspired our students: Jill Bolick, Amy Davis, Dina Byers, Becky Balla, Bernadine Fields, Sarah Catherine Jakes, and Bradley Lagoie. Please. Thank you. Thank you. And a very special thanks to those who make the performers look and sound their best: our technical support crew, our backstage management team, and our fantastic band down there in the pit. Thank y'all. Thank you. Thank you for your attendance tonight and for your support of our student performers. Thank you. And their teachers and graduates who benefit from an evening to shine, you are greatly appreciated. And we also want to shout out Dr. Catherine Edmonds, Chief of Staff at North Carolina Central University. Thank you as well. Ago.
Amen.
Ago.
Amen.
All right. Now let's give it up for our high schoolers, y'all. Make some noise for our high schoolers.
Coming down on me, you're on me.
Give it up, give it up. Give it up again for these high school students. Wonderful. Now, it's been a few years since we could gather like this due to COVID and other challenges, and I just want to take a moment to acknowledge the soloists and seniors who just performed for y'all. Can our soloists, vocalists, come up to the mic and introduce yourselves? And the dancers, too. Come on, dancers, y'all, too. All right, I want you to say your name and your school into the mic. Let's start with the soloists, and then we'll do the dancers after that. Is that cool? All right, so we'll start with you.
Hey, my name is Summer Foster, and I go to Northern High School.
I'm Jeff Lucas, and I go to Northern High School.
Hey, I'm Micah Sampson, and I go to Riverside High School.
I'm Sincere Moss, and I go to Southern High School.
My name is Everett Pendergraf, and I go to Durham School of the Arts.
Hi, my name is Ansi Lloyd, and I go to Southern.
Hi, I'm Amaya Poteet, and I go to Northern High School.
I'm Jen Arden Hodge, and I go to Riverside High School.
And I'm Kamari Carpenter, and I go to Durham School of the Arts.
Let's go. All right, so y'all three, y'all can just slide to the right, okay? And now our dancers, seniors, please introduce yourselves.
Hi, I'm Cameron Wheaton. I go to Durham School of the Arts.
Hi, I'm Abigail Zarasana, and I go to Durham School of the Arts.
I'm Trinity Powell, and I go to Northern High School.
Hi, my name is Landon Jenkins, and I go to Northern High School.
Our seniors! Thank you. DPS offers the most arts programs, after-school opportunities, and courses in this community. DPS is simply the best. And we are going to celebrate our artsy greatness by thanking the Durham Public Schools. Give them a big round of applause and a big thank you. Thank you for supporting us. Take it away.